Hey, Zach.
Yeah?
How do you like your chimichangas?
About 9 inches long. Really thick outer shell. You know, soft inside. Easy to grab with your hand. And, you know, nightly and under $8. Next question.
That's a chimichanga, all right.
How do you like your chimichanga?
Just like that. Only bigger.
What? Yeah. Hey, how's it going, guys? We are still filming out of my dad's office. Don't laugh at us.
We're too legit to quit.
Yeah, it doesn't matter where we go. We'll film in your mom's attic, in your grandma's cupboards, and your dad's fancy offices. We'll get it done. Because today we're here to bring you a Deadpool review, which I haven't seen the movie yet. Which, it's for various reasons. Mostly because I have...
No good ones. Because it's Deadpool.
No, I have a very passionate wife who wants to see the movie with me. Which you can't fault for your wife wanting to see Deadpool with you.
Oh, that's good.
So I'm going to wait.
That's a good wife.
And I'm just going to ask Charlotte some questions about Deadpool for the review. So, Charlotte, what are your overall thoughts on the movie Deadpool? Because our expectations are pretty high.
It was awesome. Everybody needs to go see it right away. Take your wife right now. Actually, stop interviewing me. Go.
Okay, she said it.
Bye.
No, it's too late. It's like 12 o'clock.
That's true. Well, there's still time. Come on, you can do this. Anyway, so Deadpool. It was funny. It was action-packed. The fight scenes were glorious. Like, beautiful dances.
How does it compare? How does it compare to, like... The hand-to-hand combat, like something on Winter Soldier. How does it compare?
Right at the same level.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
It was really good. They had the dude from Game of Thrones at screen. He played Dario, so he already had that sword training.
Oh, okay.
Too. But yeah, Ryan Reynolds. This is his movie. This was his part to play. Like, nailed it. Deadpool was so funny, and there was just like constant jokes, and every single joke hit the mark. There was not one joke that you would like.
Now, did the jokes overtake the action? Like, was it too jokey?
Well, I mean, it's Deadpool, so it's gotta have tons of jokes. But no, they did have it. It did have its serious moments. They did play those serious moments very lightly, though, because it was like, you know, Deadpool being serious. He's like, oh, I'm sick, but I'm Deadpool, so, or I'm Wade Wilson, and so I'm still gonna have a sense of humor about it. Silly, so it was really good.
Now, when I watched the review, I was sitting down with Jason and his crew from their channel and watched their Deadpool review, the guys kept mentioning the girl Angel Dust, like how amazing the actress was. And no one told me why. Why do you think they were so high on her? Why were they so high on Angel Dust? Or no, I'm serious. Why? Did
because
you sell them the Angel Dust?
She's pretty freaking she's pretty freaking cool. Like, you just have to see it and see what she does. And, I mean...
Does she fight?
She fights. Mm-hmm. Anyone that can take on Colossus.
No, we're talking about... Which one's... Wait, Angel...
Copycat is the brunette that is Wilson's girlfriend.
Oh, that's who I'm asking about.
Okay, so Copycat is his girlfriend. In the comics, she's like a purple... with white streaks in her hair. And
okay.
And she can like shapeshift. They didn't get to her being a mutant yet. Like, she's still a normal girl in the movie. She's very much just...
Now that's the thing. Is Wade Wilson a mutant in this, or is he a mutated human?
He's a mutated human.
Oh. So he doesn't have any mutant genes at all.
They basically give him an injection, and there's just this crazy torture scene. Just him getting tortured.
And please don't make the super suit green or animated.
And the torture scenes are nuts. They're straight out of a freaking war movie. And they give him this injection of the serum, and they put his body to so much stress that it eventually changes his physiology. And that's what gives him this power. And that's how all of the characters that come from that program have their abilities. And each one is different. They do show Vanessa go be put in the chamber and start the process, but it never gets finished, and it never shows you if she does or doesn't, so that's still up in the air.
Now, how does this integrate to the X-Men universe, or does it at all?
Oh, it totally does. It's got Colossus, and it's got Negasonic Teenage Warhead trying to get him to join the X-Men.
Is there any other nods to any other X-Men characters?
There's a lot of nods to Wolverine. We do get to hear about Wolverine constantly. There's actually one scene when she takes his mask off to see his face for the first time, and he staples a picture of Wolverine over his own face and cut out the eye. So she has to rip the staples out of his face so she can see him for the first time after the accident.
So I want to answer the question for everyone. Why shouldn't kids see this movie?
Surprise! This is a different kind of superhero story.
There's a lot of nudity. There's bad language, a lot of jokes, so many.
But Charlotte, my children are progressive, and I raise them to be able to push that out of their heads.
Well, that's your child.
And so, you know, why is there people standing at the front of the theater telling people, like, hey, you cannot come in here unless you're 18, even if you have a parent or guardian?
Because you see the hero just straight up have no remorse, murder, kill whoever he wants. There's strippers, prostitutes, cocaine references, guns dealers. There's just like every awful thing in the world that exists is in this movie at some point, in some scene.
So in there.
Yeah, I mean, it's just...
So basically, if you just want your kid to be exposed to everything bad in the world in about 2 hours,
yeah,
go see this movie.
Exactly. If you want to raise a child that's fun, take him to the movie. If you want a boring kid, you know, leave him at home.
Charlotte, we're telling kids not to go see the movie.
Oh yeah, don't go see the movie, kids.
There you go. But then, kids shouldn't see it. But why should everyone else see this movie, Charlotte?
Because you have all that other fun stuff.
Just for the same reason why kids shouldn't have it.
Kids can't see it.
Because that's why they should.
It's a funny story. You get to have an adult superhero story. Like, it's all the superhero movies. Like, I love all of them, most of them. But most of them, you know, they are made for children. They don't push it. Like, when you read a comic book, you see things that kids shouldn't see. In the comics, there's violence, gore, death, eyeballs, explosions. And, like, Deadpool's so true to the comics. There's all that stuff that, you know, the Avengers skip out on, and you don't see in Iron Man. Like, they don't touch on his alcoholism. They don't go into the deeper issues of a person. Or Deadpool, because it's not for children, they don't want children there. They can hit those issues. They can talk about those deeper problems.
Do you think anybody else now, since this movie's being so successful, short answer, do you think now you'll see more rated R comic movies come out?
I still don't think so. I think that, you know, kids are the most marketable audience. All the items that they can sell, all that, I think it's just, they're going to stick. And Marvel's just had such a successful formula. I don't see them deviating from that. I totally hope Fox takes cues and makes X-Men movies that are a little bit more, that push the envelope a little more. That would be really exciting.
Awesome. Well, I'm really excited to go see it. Charlotte, thank you so much for getting me psyched up. Now my expectations are like...
Expectations?
I got a little Southern in me when I see a
y'all
woman
go
just
see that movie.
Open her chest in front of me. I was just looking, I was like, Deadpool. Oh, cool. Tell us what you guys seeing in the movie. We're gonna be doing follow-up stuff on it here in the future. LA's actually seeing it right now. So please comment below. Tell us what you thought of the movie. And do you think we're gonna see more rated R movies? And do you think children should see this movie at all? Oh, please. I want to wait for the person in the comment section that actually has a good argument for that. But thank you guys so much.
Bye.